I'm Lieutenant Sarah Alvarez. It's going to be S-A-R-A and then Alvarez, A-L-V-A-R-E-Z. Yep, I'm a 15 Alpha, and I'm a platoon leader and Apache pilot. Yep, my unit is 36 ACS, I'm Charlie Troop, PL, and my hometown would be Alamosa, Colorado. Yeah, so my job title is a platoon leader, so I lead a platoon of pilots and crew chiefs, and I fly Apaches. So I went the officer route. I was looking at ways to pay for college, and I was offered an ROTC scholarship, so Army paid for my college, and I continued to serve because I fell in love with the job and the idea of leading people. The advice I'd give to somebody wanting to join the Army is find something that you like doing. The Army has so many different positions available and jobs that you can do. So find something that you're passionate about and something that you're going to be happy doing every day. Aside from flying in general, I think that the gunnery that we conducted out here in, or the gunnery up in Latvia, has been my favorite experience, getting to actually go out and shoot and see the Apache and all its capabilities has been my favorite experience. So the gunnery wasn't actually a competition, but it was how we qualify on, like you would qualify on your weapon system. We qualify in the Apache, so it's shooting rockets, Hellfires, and then the 30 millimeter. So I serve to be part of something bigger than myself, and I serve to help those under me and be a leader. And I really strive to be a servant leader, so to make the organization better as a whole. Women's History Month is an opportunity to recognize the women who have gone before and really broke through the glass ceiling. Ann Dunwoody was the first female four-star general, and that's super inspiring, and I think it's a chance to recognize women who are doing great things all across the Army and organizations as a whole, really celebrating the how far women have come. So the woman in my life that inspires me the most would be my mom. She's always taught us to finish what you start, to give it your 100%, and she has always done that by example, and so it's super inspiring to watch her continue to strive for her goals and encourage me and my sister to do the same. I would say that the lessons that she has taught me in life has definitely affected how I lead and the way I go about my everyday life in the Army, yes. So the advice I'd give my younger self would be to continue to strive for your dreams and goals, to always go after the things that you believe in, and to keep challenging yourself. Because you're going to go do great things no matter what it is. For upcoming female leaders in the Army, I would tell you to reach out and find female support system around you and to reach out and support those around you because the only way that females are going to continue to be successful and continue to break through that glass ceiling is by really supporting each other and being there for each other. I'd like to give a shout out to my husband. He also is in the Army, and no matter where we're at career-wise, he has been my biggest supporter, and I'd just like to thank him for being there for me every day.